Welcome to Suncoast View. I'm Stephanie Roberts. New downtown development details in Suncoast cities, and Forbes finds Florida number one.
I'm Rebecca Vargas, and river cruises are the fastest growing segment of the cruise industry. Today, our travel expert tells us what they're all about.
I'm Bo Beth. When you talk real estate, they say the most important thing is location, location, and location. And here in Suncoast for Sale, we're going to find the best properties in our area.
And I'm Linda Carson. Life is a cabaret at the Venice Theater for the next few weeks, and we kick off their summer cabaret festival with the Rat Pack. All that and more right now in Suncoast View.
Welcome to the show, and welcome back to Rebecca Vargas.
Thank you for having me. It's always good to be with the ladies.
It's always
on a
fun
Wednesday.
To have you.
Yeah, thank you.
Wednesday's always a good day because that means Chef Judy is in the kitchen. And wow, is she there today? She's got bread upon bread upon bread stacked high. What is in all those buns?
What's in those buns? Italian sausages. And let me tell you, you know, Rebecca, it's amazing how you get here on Wednesdays.
It's like you
My
do.
Official little petite sausage sandwich taster. We have gone from Valentino's, both spots, Geyer's, wait till you see the mini brat sausages. It's sausage parmesan from Piccolo's. These places are so good. We are going to have such a great tasting today, and I just can hardly wait.
Oh, yummy.
It's a sausage party.
It is.
It really is, though. It is.
It's summer, and it's time for Italian sausage sandwiches.
It's always time for something Italian.
There you go.
Yeah, I got you, Rebecca. I got you on that.
They're all ignoring me, but that's all right. I'm just stating the obvious. It's a movie, you know. It's a movie.
It is.
Which, by the way, no one in my house is going to see. Just thought I'd say that. All right, we're going to move right on after that one.
Please do.
Time for our first hot topic, and downtown development continues in both Bradenton and Sarasota. Sarasota City Commissioners voted to approve upscale restaurant and craft cocktail bar Cascade Ale on Main Street. Supporters brought up the need to attract and keep younger residents in Sarasota. Cascade Ale is another location in St. Pete. They say they'll be ready to be open in a couple of months. In Bradenton, Old Main Street is getting a facelift with better lighting and wider sidewalks. A new hotel and parking garage are also on the way. What do we think? Do we think attracting younger residents should be a priority for us?
Yes.
I think
absolutely.
It is.
I think it's about time we have stuff like this. Because, I mean, if you look at, like, St. Pete along the water, they have all of these new trendy places for people to go to. I mean, we do have some club feels maybe on the quay or something, but there's nothing for young people here. I'm so glad we have a loungy, upscale, but fun, trendy, you know, place coming to our area.
I agree totally, but I think it's bigger than that. I think it's also, if you want a community to thrive, you have to have a variety of age ranges, because if you have only one age range, once they're gone, what do you have?
Yeah. Well,
and I think that's what happened previously.
I'm an older person, and I would totally go there.
You'll love it.
Oh, that's good.
Yes, yep. So people my age will go there, too. So it'll just attract more people to our area and more life downtown. There's nothing worse than walking through a dead downtown.
That's what kind of like Bradenton is, too. I feel like the downtown Bradenton, that just that Main Street area, while it has a great historical feel, you definitely want some life brought back in there. Because I feel like it could be a really thriving area. It's so nice over there, right by the water.
It has a lot of charm. It does.
And nowadays, like, you go down that street, it's like, it is packed with a bunch of restaurants and a bunch of people. So, you know, I think the more the merrier, because there's people here looking for things to do. So let's give us something to do.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
We're attracting the tourists. Now we need to keep them coming and moving here with stuff to do.
Yeah, so keep them staying here for longer periods of time.
All right, thumbs up.
Maybe
all
not just the tourists,
here.
Just me. Give me something to do, please.
We like stuff to do here. Well, we must be doing something right. Forbes magazine is reporting the 10 cities that Americans are moving to right now based on realtor data. Florida is at the top of the list thanks to a rebounding housing market and good job creation. Tampa coming in at number one from Forbes magazine. The median home price there, $230,000, and there's a 4.4% unemployment rate, which is considered very low. Jacksonville, this shocked me, comes in at number two. Orlando coming in at number 7. Remember, wow, this is based on realty data. This is where people are buying homes. Mm-hmm. 2 Texas cities and 2 North Carolina cities were also part of the top 10. Boy, I guess we're done with our housing issues, huh?
Yeah,
but you know, I wish we're not in the top 10 there. I see Sarasota and Bradenton and Venice, and that's because we need more jobs. We need more well-paying jobs. So as that comes in, it'll be better for all of us.
Yeah, well, I'd agree with that. More corporate structure.
But it's hard to find those companies to relocate to the, mm-hmm, the area.
So I wonder if it's just because for so long this area has been known as a retirement, mm-hmm, place. I mean, you know, seeing some corporate places moving down here, moving their headquarters here, it's just been happening in the recent years, I feel like. But maybe it's because of that stigma and because Tampa or Jacksonville or Orlando has more of a metropolitan, right, urban feel.
Yeah. You can get a job there.
Right.
Well,
so
not
maybe
just
that's
that,
what it is.
So there's been a lot of complaints, and I'm going probably way too into it, but they're saying that the workforce isn't here. A lot of companies are worried, mm-hmm, that the people they need to hire, mm-hmm, aren't here.
Oh, we could find them.
I believe so, too.
The people here have children that would love to work here, but there aren't good, well-paying jobs.
So they ended up graduating and going off.
Yeah, graduating from college and going somewhere else.
But I think you have to have the companies here first, because I'm not going to stay as a millennial or even
knowing it's
someone
not even here,
in the middle of their career if the job isn't going to be here. So.
Right. Which makes sense.
I mean,
you know, different cities and counties try to work with the different people, give them tax, mm-hmm, incentives and things to come here. But again, you're competing against places all across the country.
Yeah,
and
right,
if you don't have a lot of things in place, you know, we end up losing out. I know there was a couple deals, like there was this a huge controversy a couple weeks ago about a national company that did roofing construction. And, mm-hmm, you know, we didn't get that bid. And that would have created over 200 and something jobs.
Yeah. Well, and say what you will about Governor Scott, but he has made that a priority. So
Forest
hopefully
State,
the creation and the employment opportunities will continue.
But nice, some our way.
Nice to see those rankings. Well, the next iOS update on your iPhone will have a new option. It's a one-touch button to sign up to be an organ donor. It'll be part of that health information app. Those come installed on every Apple iPhone. So the option would enroll you in the National Donor Registry, and that's a cause close to Apple after co-founder Steve Jobs had to wait a very long time for a liver transplant in 2009 because there are simply not enough national donor matches. What do you think about this? I have a feeling a lot of people don't even know that health information app exists.
No, I didn't know anything.
I didn't know that.
Well, I signed up on my driver's license, I believe, but I called not long ago to be a bone marrow donor, and they said, "How old are you?" And when I told them, they said, "No, thanks."
Oh. They don't want your bone marrow.
They're like, "Okay, I'll take my organs, but not my bone." But my marrow.
Bones are still good.
Yeah.
I guess mine.
I don't even know if I have that. And you said it's on your license.
Yeah, they should ask you when you get your license.
It's actually literally a line that says organ donor, like in red.
Yeah. But if you were flying through it and putting in your information, you might not do it. That doesn't mean you don't want to.
I was, you know, like 16 the last time I really looked at that. I only needed to get it upgraded, I think, one time.
Yeah.
I moved to Florida. So.
But there's a downside, because even if you have it on your license, they still will ask the person that is your
next of kin.
Yeah. Right.
Because so you can have it on your license all you want. Sometimes if you don't have that conversation with your family members,
they can keep it. We'll have to find out if that's true with the iPhone, too. Something tells me just because it's punched on your iPhone may not
it. That's what confuses me, too, with, you know, technology and apps and things like that. How concrete is
they
it?
Go right.
Well, yeah, you know, that's the one thing I wonder.
But I think it's important, because if you're not going to use it, if you're, you know, have passed or something happened, you know, give another person an opportunity
to live.
And at least it gives this an easier way to make that happen. Well, speaking of iPhones, we know the next generation is addicted to technology, but now we may have a better idea of why. A UCLA study found that in the developing brains of teenagers, getting likes on social media was found to generate activity in the regions of the brain that sense pleasure. So it puts a new importance on just how influential that little heart-shaped like button is on sites like Instagram in the minds of teens. Mm-hmm. Researchers say the amount of likes may be guiding teens' behavior so that they can fit in and be liked by their peers. Interestingly, though, it does not appear to be increasing any negative behaviors. I'll tell you what, I live this every day with the teenagers in my house. They compete constantly. Who has the most followers?
Really?
Who has the most likes? It's like the new way of feeling accepted. Whereas in our world, it might have been how many people,
you couldn't count
a note.
You couldn't count how popular you were.
You
now
really couldn't.
That's true. If I think, I mean, I'm in the generation where I think Instagram and these apps came in. I was in college, so I did have the before we had the whole cell phones and the apps. And true, your recognition was really only in if you were involved in a certain sport or if you were in a certain clique. but what couldn't be measured.
Yes.
I wonder, I mean, it's a,
it's good and bad.
It's detrimental, you know, it makes you feel bad about yourself.
It makes me feel good to get likes.
It does.
The most likes I ever got was when I complained about a cable company.
And then you got my heart.
And that was last week.
Like, they agree with me.
You know, I kind of agree. When you post a picture and you see, you know, hundreds of people have seen it, liked it, you thought, okay, that's nice. People are reading my stuff.
Is it just me?
Like, but that doesn't care. She's like, whatever.
And don't let me get me wrong of saying, like, I appreciate the likes because I don't want to sound like, you know, not appreciative. Right. But at the same time, it does not make or break my day at all.
Yeah,
like
half
of the time, I don't even notice.
And so it doesn't make or break my day.
But I do
sure
notice.
It gives me a warm, fuzzy feeling.
I do notice. And I think in an immature teen mind, it more than makes or breaks their day. Like, I mean, it's a big deal. And the problem I have noticed is that, you know, the kids post when they do absolutely everything. Well, then you see someone doing something without you. So then you start to feel bad about yourself.
That's
and,
true.
You know, I have
but
to say, don't. That does bother me.
Because then you're now you're looking for your acceptance through other people. And you have to learn how to accept yourself within yourself. Like, you can't, you know,
wait
on likes.
Or you're showing something or a version of yourself. They say social media is like your highlight reel. Don't compare yourself to other people.
Exactly.
You're not going to show when you're down. You're showing only the best parts of you.
And I have to remind myself of that on a weekend where I'm cleaning the garage all weekend and everybody else is at the beach. Yeah. Everybody's doing this.
It really makes you feel lousy, doesn't it?
It does. But guess what? The people who are cleaning the garage, like me, didn't post it.
Yeah. Exactly. I was with you. I was cleaning out my garage on Saturday and I thought, I ought to post this picture. Then I looked in the mirror.
It says, don't even take the picture.
My, how the world has changed. Well, contestants are suing a pageant over the judge's choice of the winner. 25-year-old Caitlin Cifuentes was crowned Miss Corpus Christi Latina, but her competitors say her past should have disqualified her. Cifuentes had a prior marriage. She's also on probation for assault with a deadly weapon and misdemeanor DUI. The pageant director says the rules say a contestant cannot currently be married, but that divorce was deemed okay, and that probation is different than a conviction, which is not allowed. The director goes on to say, just because you have had a bad background doesn't mean it should hold you back from accomplishing your goals.
I agree with him to some extent. I feel like when you win a certain pageant, you're a representative of that agency or the organization. So you want the best, the person that has the best standards throughout their lives, not saying that you can't make mistakes. But at the same time, who is the sore loser that is suing the organization because they're
all upset. Of them? Yeah. They all the other contestants grouped together.
Well, you know what? That's unfortunate because you maybe should have done better.
And
you know whose fault is it that you didn't beat out this? You know,
and a pageant, it doesn't belong to the public. It's just a company putting it on to make money or to get prestige or something. So it's up to the sponsor to say what they want.
Exactly.
They may want a girl. They don't care about her background.
It does show that they are a sore loser. I do agree with that. I didn't even think about that. The only thing I thought, first of all, was, okay, totally okay with the divorce thing. I mean, she's single, so it's fine. She's a part of that. I think the probation thing, I think that
assault with a deadly weapon is a little concerning for me.
I feel like if she was already, it was all blown over, and that was in her, because I'm all about second chances. I think that, you know, people have rebounded, and your life still means something great, and you can do something amazing. But she was still on probation.
Yeah.
If she was off of probation, if that was like way in her past, but she's like kind of still on it.
So I'm so ridiculous. You ever heard the bracelets?
Awkward.
What if she was like, had to wear that bracelet?
Right. She's like, I got to go back home after this.
Can you imagine how ridiculous that would be?
I think the pageant set their own standards.
Yeah.
And you know, my first beauty contest I won was Miss Carroll County Poultry Princess. And I'm not sure what the standard
is. Do you like poultry?
Linda?
She ate chicken. That was the standard.
She raised chickens on her farm.
No,
being a poultry princess is funny.
It's definitely a mixed bag because part of me says, you know, what during the competition they weren't judging her on that. They were judging on the standards that they had set for the competition. So, you know, those girls should have done better or did whatever, answered whatever question or presented well. And she won fairly, so, you know, who are we to judge her, I guess.
Somebody's always suing someone. That's what it seems like. Well, extreme sports just got a little more extreme. Check out this human catapult. It launches, I call them victims, people, over 300 feet in the sky. This makes me crazy. This is in Dubai. Look at this.
Why?
You go from 0 to 124 miles per hour in a second.
That's awesome.
Is 6 G's of force. Then the parachute guides you safely back to Earth, because not only are you tethered, but they also have to break the speed at which the tether brings you back down.
The parachute hopefully
brings you back to Earth. It reminds me of that thing in Orlando. There's that slingshot on iDrive, but it's not nearly that huge.
This is like a bad idea.
Yeah, we have people here in Sarasota that do that professionally. A human cannonball.
Right.
Yeah, in the circus.
Right.
They get paid for
that. They're professionals.
Yes. I would not be launched in a
slingshot. And that person paid for that.
124 miles per hour. Yeah.
I'm all about the thrill, and I would do stuff like this, but that just concerns me. Just the parachute, the G-force of that strong, and a parachute opening up. No.
Yeah, and when you get sick, it's right back on your face. So it's just
It's a whiplash when you stop. Can you imagine?
All right. We're going to check in with our happy hour forecast. When we come back, we're going to find all about the new travel trend of river cruising.
Yeah, that kind of activity is a little too daredevil for me as well. But I'll tell you what, we had some pretty strong winds around here today that created some issues on some of our area roadways. Talk about that in a second. Right now, we have some cloud cover in inland areas and a few clouds out in Gulf waters. The clouds in inland areas are caused by showers and thunderstorms. In fact, if we put the radar loop into motion, you see the big storm near Bradenton at about 2 o'clock this afternoon. That one turned over some tractor trailer trucks and also took down a stand of palm trees. So I guess about 60 mile an hour winds with that storm. Right now we have one storm that's located just to the north of the I-75 bend, and mostly in areas of the state park. But otherwise, high pressure remains right over us, and therefore we don't have a whole lot of activity. We'll probably have a pretty light evening thunderstorm chance near the coastline, where most of the storms will be in inland areas. But boy, will it be warm.
Welcome back. The cruise line industry continues to be hot, and river cruises are the industry's fastest growing segment. River cruises only make up about 5% of the market right now, but 18 new ships are being added worldwide this year. So travel expert John Sutter is joining us from Landings Travel with some tips on deciding if river cruises are right for you. John, welcome.
Thank you.
I love to cruise. I just came back from one, but obviously on the ocean. We're so interested in,
yes,
in river cruising.
Yes. It's How's the hottest thing going.
It is, most
How
definitely.
Is it different from, or else alike? I don't
know
what's the difference.
It's different and it's the same. Mm-hmm. Of course, with the river cruises, the ships are going to be much smaller. Mm-hmm. So it's a little more intimate.
Okay.
You still do the same things in the different cities. You have shore excursions for each city that you go to.
Oh, so that was my concern. I want to see these places.
Right.
I just don't want to go floating by them.
Sure, sure. So with the ocean cruise, you end up docking in an industrial port in most of the cities and most of the ports. With a river cruise, you're docking right in the middle of town.
Oh, wow.
All the commerce in the Middle Ages was in the middle of the city and on the rivers. So when you get off the riverboat, it's from here to 20 feet away. You're in the old village, the old town area, so there's so much to see and do.
And I've never heard of this in the United States. So did this start in Europe, abroad, in other countries? You know, where did this type of travel begin?
River cruising actually started in Europe. It's been over there for quite some time now. It's interesting how you mentioned there was 18 new boats coming online. Mm-hmm. There's actually over 250 river boats on the rivers now.
Right now,
yeah, there's 250 plus.
So many.
Wow. Yeah. So that means there's a variety of different trips. So tell us, like, what can people do? Like, what are some of the options out
there? What's the most popular?
Well, they're all popular. And what's interesting when you bring that up, because people say, well, I want to go on a river cruise this year. So really, you should be planning a year in advance because they're so popular, they'll sell out very quickly.
And
they're
smaller boats,
they're
like
smaller
you said.
Okay. Boats, 120 to 200 people maximum.
Oh, wow. How long are they? How many days do they take?
They go anywhere from 3 days to over 20 days.
Wow.
It depends on where you're going. And you've got, of course, France. You've got Italy. You've got Germany, Hungary, Czechoslovakia, of course, cruising down the Danube River or the Moselle or the Rhine. So each river offers something different in regards to what you're going to do.
What if you don't mention there's some in America now?
Yeah. There is, as a matter of fact. There are two different cruise lines in America, that river cruises, that is, that do the Mississippi River, the Cumberland, and the Ohio, and also the Snake River. And they're a little bit smaller boats. Some of them are actual paddle wheelers, like the old Mississippi Queen and things like that.
So I was going to ask, obviously, you know, the big concern for a lot of people getting on cruises, the seasickness. I mean, you can't get away from the waves on the ocean.
Exactly.
Is this good for somebody that's ever wanted a cruise because of how rivers are so...
Rivers, if you think about a river cruise, we could be sitting on a river cruise boat right now and feel the same amount of motion that we do now.
Really?
That's, none.
Yeah, I mean,
absolutely
that can't
none.
Be that
because
bad.
The rivers are very smooth to begin with, and the boats are very low to the water, so there's not a lot of back and forth sway. And there's really no wakes on the river, so they just go along at a slow speed. And really, the only way you know you're moving is if you look out and see a tree going by you or another boat.
My other question was, there's perks on cruises, as in you pay for it all up front. Everything is pretty much included when you get on the boat. There's also activities to do. A lot of that can be included.
Correct.
What does it look like on a river cruise? Is it upfront cost or?
Well, you've got your choice with river cruises. There are some that they, for the majority, all include shore excursions. So when you get to the different cities, you do a self-guided or a guided tour from the boat with a tour guide. And they'll offer different levels of activity. So if you're not interested in doing something strenuous, of course, you can go on a much less strenuous trip, or you can walk as much as you want. They also offer bicycles in the different towns. So you can actually get on a bike and go for a bike ride.
That's nice.
Some of the river cruises will drop you off in one city and pick you up in another city, and you can ride the distance.
That's neat.
But the bicycles, what's great about them is there are some that are electric assist. So,
so you
can start
the pedal.
Well, you start the pedal and then you just cruise right along.
Oh,
so
it's
great.
Like
so
it's
self-driving. Not as much work as you would think it is. So it's actually a lot of fun. Right.
You can get used to that.
But also with the river cruises, there are some that include everything. So you pay one price up front and everything is all there. You don't pay for your gratuities because it's included. Your airfare is included.
Wow.
All your shore excursions are included. The food, of course.
Well, I need a vacation.
And if you're interested in adult beverages, they're included as well.
Wow.
I think this sounds like our next trip.
Oh, this sounds wonderful. Yes, but a year in advance. Oh, my.
Yeah.
I've got to get busy.
There's still space now.
There is. Yeah. See, Linda, you can go book your trip.
Yes.
We're still in summer. All right.
And I actually know a pretty good travel consultant that could help you.
Oh, do you?
Yes. Yes, indeed.
Well, if you want more information, just go to thelandingstravel.com. You can find out more information there. Thank you, John, so much for being with us. So interested in these river cruises. And coming up, we take a look at the hottest Hollywood headlines.
Hurricane season is here, and Suncoast weather can go from this to this in seconds. So when severe weather threatens, count on the official Suncoast storm team at ABC 7.
We're armed with the most advanced weather technology so that we can bring you storm warnings faster and with more detail than ever before.
Plus, we focus on the Suncoast and track storms right down to your neighborhood.
On air, online, and on your mobile device, turn to the official Suncoast storm team at ABC 7. We're here for you. Hurricane season is here, and so is the official Suncoast Hurricane Guide from ABC 7. This essential resource arms you with vital information you need to protect your family and property when severe weather threatens the Suncoast, including how to create your readiness plan and survival kit, shelter locations, what to do with pets, and important phone numbers. Visit mysuncoast.com and download the official Suncoast Hurricane Guide from ABC 7. Brought to you by the Florida Lottery.
Tonight on ABC 7 News at 7.
One of the pieces that we found out is there just what, while we communicated quite a bit through that rollout, there wasn't enough interaction with the community.
Parking meters coming back to downtown Sarasota. Find out what the city is doing to avoid the mistakes they made last time they were brought in and then removed. I'm Ray Collins. That plus our roundtable discussion.
Tonight on ABC 7 News at 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
On your TV, on your computer, on your camera, on your smartphone, on your Apple Watch. And now you can get ABC 7, your Suncoast News, on Roku. Just go to mysuncoast.com and click on the mobile tab for a list of fast and free downloads that deliver ABC 7, your Suncoast News, on the go.
Looks like we're getting another new neighbor.
Now you could be the millionaire next door. Play Monopoly Florida Edition scratch-off games with a top prize of $5 million. The Florida Lottery. Just imagine.
Welcome back. BET controversy tops our Hollywood headlines. We talked last week about Grey's Anatomy actor Jesse Williams' passionate speech about race in the U.S. Now there are petitions asking for his removal from Grey's Anatomy, saying his BET speech was racist hate speech against law enforcement and white people. The petition actually refers back to the Grey's history when Isaiah Washington was let go in 2007 after he used a gay slur during an argument with castmate Patrick Dempsey. So creator Shonda Rhimes weighs in today, saying Williams does not need a petition for or against him. Hashtag Shonda Land rules. Should actors be punished for their statements?
I don't think this is a statement that he should be punished for. People are upset about it because it's true. Anytime you know, everyone always wants to rally behind all these different issues, but the reality of the situation is many minorities feel unappreciated. We are always treated differently in certain situations, and this man just called it out. He called a spade, and now everyone is upset about it. I can tell you, my brother gets pulled over by a cop, he's going to be treated differently than someone else that is not the same color as him. That's a fact. Simple point blank.
And did he say anything that hateful?
It wasn't hateful. It's just the fact that he's calling out things that people don't want to address. No one wants to ever have that race conversation because it's uncomfortable, and I get it, but it's the reality of a lot of people. So just to say it doesn't exist or you don't like it just because you don't understand it doesn't mean it's the same. And, you know, I hate to go into, like, the whole get on my soap dish, but the reality of the situation in
soap
every
box.
Instance...
Oh,
there, yeah.
Soap
that's dish. Right. Now, a dish wouldn't be very
soap dishes
high.
Are small. Well, and maybe... that the right place? Maybe that's the other discussion. We had that discussion.
But that was what the award was for his humanitarian efforts. So, you know, if he went up there and talked about his efforts, and that's what he was, you know, talking about. And, again, the reality is when blacks are shot by a police officer, and you can't tell me in every instance, and there's been multiple, and there's never been a conviction? Come on. What does that say? It's okay to shoot us. That's the message that sends. And then when people speak up for it, they say, oh, no, it's wrong. There's always excuses when something like that happens to why the person was shot or why the person was killed. Officers are able de-escalate situations with other races without violence. Why can't they de-escalate situations with black without violence?
And that was his point, and I think it brings up the general bigger question for everybody about when Hollywood people make statements, does it reflect back on their jobs? And in this case, Shonda Rhimes said, no. Enough already.
I think it's
ridiculous. He's perfectly fine.
Well, who's getting the petition up? It doesn't seem like
doesn't
it's
matter
their
at this
business.
Point. It was
well,
on
no, they have a lot of petitions. I think it's like
four against. We got it going every which way. Yeah. But Shonda rules, she said. She's in charge. She says he is just fine.
I just think this whole thing is ridiculous.
All right, coming up next, a preview of the Venice Cabaret Festival.
Have you ever wondered what it's like to save a life? Find out by donating platelets at Suncoast Blood Bank.
I'm Haley Wilgus, ABC 7. Platelets aid in the clotting process and are vital in the treatment of cancer and surgical patients, trauma victims, and critically ill newborns. It's tough to keep enough on the shelves because they only last 5 days. To donate, call this number or visit scbb.org, and you can help save a life.
ABC 7 congratulates Suncoast Blood Bank on 65 years of serving our community.
At ABC 7, our entire weathercast is dedicated to the Suncoast, and now we bring it to you like never before with the all-new official Suncoast forecast.
Beach and boating forecast. The winds will be out of the northwest at 10 knots.
Now, with the most advanced graphics and technology, we bring you weather where you live, pinpointing right down to your neighborhood.
Zooming into the Sarasota Bayfront,
the all-new official Suncoast forecast, only on ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
We're losing exotic animals on a daily basis, and the ones that we have in captivity are really the ambassadors for their wild counterparts. I'm Clayton Rozier from the Big Cat Habitat and Gulf Coast Sanctuary, housing over 150 exotic animals that needed a great home. And if you love animals, please help them. Do it locally. Support your local no-kill shelters, your local wild animal sanctuaries. Make a difference where you can.
tonight on ABC 7 News at 7.
One of the pieces that we found out is there just what, while we communicated quite a bit through that rollout, there wasn't enough interaction with the community.
Parking meters coming back to downtown Sarasota to find out what the city is doing to avoid the mistakes they made last time they were brought in and then removed. I'm Ray Collins. That plus our roundtable discussion.
Tonight on ABC 7 News at 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you. At ABC 7, it's all about being here for you. ABC 7 News at 7, with award-winning investigative journalist Alan Cohn. In-depth reporting and debate on important issues and stories in our community, with a featured topic of the day and a live roundtable discussion with community leaders and newsmakers, plus a quick recap of the day's top stories and weather. ABC 7 News at 7, weeknights. Now more than ever, we're here for you, Suncoast. On your TV, on your computer, on your camera, on your smartphone, on your Apple Watch. And now you can get ABC 7, your Suncoast News, on Roku. Just go to mysuncoast.com and click on the mobile tab for a list of fast and free downloads that deliver ABC 7, your Suncoast News, on the go.
Welcome back to Suncoast View. We're going to check back into the kitchen with Chef Judy, who's featuring Italian sausage sandwiches. And Judy, part of the key seems to be the bread. Wow, does that look amazing.
Isn't this incredible? Piccolo's Italian Market, one of my faves down in Gulfgate, had all these artisan breads brought in. Now, it's very important on the sandwich, the great bread, but think about getting a loaf like this, have them cut it, okay, and then fill it with sausage and peppers, and ooh, that is your party right there, right?
I'll tell you what.
Right? I know. Mama loves
amazing.
The bread.
Yep, nope, the bread is part of it. We are going to be sampling soon. Can't wait to join you, Linda.
Summer just got a little bit hotter in Venice in a good way. The Suncoast Best Entertainers will be on stage at the Venice Theater for the annual Summer Cabaret Festival. There'll be different performers every couple of days. It is a great way to see a wide range of local talent when many of the local theaters are dark for the summer. Joining us now with all the details is Lori Colton. She's the marketing director with the Venice Theater. What a great idea, Lori.
We're so excited. It's our fourth annual.
Oh. Wow, it seems like it just got started. Uh-huh. How did it get started? It was such a brainstorm for somebody.
Alan Kohler, who's our producing director, he knew of so many talented people in the area that could put on their own individual shows, and summertime was a great time to do it because, like you said, theaters tend to be a little quieter in the summer, so all of these great actors and performers are available to perform for us in their own shows.
So everybody plans their own show.
They do.
So each one is totally different.
Each one is totally different. We have gospel singers, we have jazz singers, we have Broadway folks. I mean, every style of music you can think of.
And they come, do you change every week?
It's every Thursday weekend. Through Sunday. And every couple of days you have new acts.
That's fun.
We had a great group of teenagers a couple years ago.
Oh.
Who were fantastic, one of the best shows that I saw. Joey, your producer, done a show with us.
And Joey is going to be doing another one, I understand.
Joey is going to be a guest performer in the cabaret that I'm doing in a couple of weeks.
You're doing one. Oh,
yep.
I can't wait to see that one.
Thank you.
And Sarita Banks, now she's going to be doing one, right?
She is opening the festival tomorrow night, Thursday and Friday. She'll be performing Broadway Soul. Yeah. Check this out.
Wonderful.
She's actually pretty well known in the area because she was in Orlando doing the Lion King show at Animal Kingdom, and she did the big Circle of Life solo.
Yes,
I bet you've seen her. Yeah,
and she was incredible. I was thinking that I wonder where they find this incredible talent, because she was incredible.
And that's amazing that we have her now.
And we have her now. She started with us. She went away. She's
back.
And she'll probably end up in New York City at some point.
And so she's this weekend.
She's this weekend, and so is. You have called him, I think, the Suncoast favorite entertainer, Suncoast crooner, the Suncoast.
You're talking about John Russo.
He's like our own Frank Sinatra in Sarasota,
he is,
right?
He is awesome and very handsome, too.
He is handsome.
And he is going
Johnny's
to do
blushing
a
right
Rat
now.
Pack tribute. Johnny Russo.
Yes.
Take it away.
Oh, he's here.
He's here.
Came blowing in from across the sea. It lingered there to touch your hair. Walk with me. All summer long, we sang a song and we strolled the golden sand. Two sweethearts and the summer wind. Like painted kites, the days and nights went flying by. The world was new beneath the blue umbrella sky. Then softer than a piper man, one day it called to you. I lost you to the summer wind. The autumn winds and the winter winds have come and gone. And still the days, the lonely days, they go on and on. Guess who sighs his lullabies through nights that never end? My fickle friend, the summer wind. Warm summer wind. Oh, the summer wind. Ooh, the summer wind.
Oh,
thank you very much.
Awesome. Great tribute. What do you like about the Venice Cabaret? Now, you sing all over.
The Venice Cabaret is an intimate space, first of all. Second of all, the organization itself is so wonderful and warm and friendly. I did a La Caja Fall. I had the lead there about 10, 12 years ago.
Wow.
And Sandy, Brad, Murray, Alan, I mean, everybody, it's just family. It's wonderful.
It's great for the audience because you are so close.
It's incredible.
And I'm looking into your eyes.
And he's good at that part, that sing
yes,
right too.
Hey, baby.
Right now.
Yours is the 9th and the 10th, right?
Yes, it
Venice
is.
Venice Cabaret
yes, is.
In Venice, 9th yep, and the yep. 10th. And for more information, you can go to the VeniceStage.com. You can find out who's going to be there. So many of your favorites are going to be there. And it runs through August 28th. Lori's going to be there. Joey's going to be there. You've got to see these guys. So go to VeniceStage.com. And next, the Suncoast for sale.
ABC7's Pump Patrol, a list of the Suncoast's cheapest gas on MySuncoast.com.
They took that stress and that tension when I was particularly feeling very bad after that nasty car accident, and it was such a relief to know that I didn't have to bear that burden alone, that I had help.
Our goal is to not just get a satisfactory settlement on their case, we want them up on their feet, happy again. They've gotten their life back.
From our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is an ABC7 News Update.
Good afternoon, I'm Healy Wilkes. Here's what we're working on for 5 o'clock. Stricter rules in Longboat Key, what the town is changing to better protect sea turtles. Plus, more free Wi-Fi. A Venice businessman steps up to make the internet more accessible in the city of Venice. Now, let's check in with John.
Well, we're looking at some pretty big storms around the region today. We had one large storm just outside of Palmetto. Actually did some damage, knocked over a couple of tractor trailers and took out a stand of palm trees. We also have some Showers in inland areas currently. Most everything is east of the interstate, and that's where it's going to stay. The biggest of the storms now in Myakka State Park. Forecast for this evening calls for pleasant conditions, but warm conditions. Temperatures will range from 92 down to about 88 this evening, with a few inland showers.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7. We're here for you.
On the Suncoast.
And across America, the news you care about
is on your Suncoast News at 5.
And ABC World News Tonight at 6:30.
People you trust. Scott Dennis, Haley Wilkes, David Muir.
First, the Suncoast.
And then, the world.
Are you or a loved one currently suffering from chronic knee pain, arthritis, or osteoarthritis of the knee? Has physical therapy, surgery, steroid injections, ibuprofen, and other NSAIDs failed to provide relief? Then you may be a candidate for our Advanced Arthritis Relief Protocol. The AARP program utilizes the latest fluoroscopic guidance technology to deliver a new joint fluid supplement that cushions the knee and reduces pain. Specialized knee bracing is then applied to unload the knee and increase joint space. Finally, advanced rehabilitative therapies are performed to strengthen the muscles and ligaments of the knee. When combined, these treatments have helped many patients reduce or even eliminate their joint pain and return to normal active lifestyles. The best part is the AARP program is covered by most insurance, including Medicare. Tired of living with knee pain? Then call the number on your screen right now to see if you qualify for our Advanced Arthritis Relief Protocol.
I'm Ray Collins. Parking meters in downtown Sarasota. The city wants them back, but what will be different this time around?
Tonight on ABC 7 News at 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
And welcome back. The real estate market is shifting, and that's why in today's Suncoast for Sale, we're looking at a variety of properties. And who better to help us navigate it through it all than our old friend, Andrew Haddad. Welcome back, Andrew.
Thank you, and Babette.
You're like the best. We've missed you so much. So we're really happy you're back. And so now you're with CERT Sarasota Homes.
Yep, still with Keller Williams for many years, and I'm with CERT Sarasota Homes. They're phenomenal. So, and I'm happy to be back. I really
miss you. We're so glad to have you.
You've got the talent of digging up the best homes for sale
ever.
And he did, because you got a variety of ranges all the way from first home to up to the millions.
Up to the millions in the dream home. We're going to do it just like before. And
all right,
I like to start it low, though.
All right, well,
it's not a misprint. This is $85,000 in Sarasota. This is awesome. This is a real popular community. This is in Village Brook of Sarasota, maintenance free. And I love to bring this because a lot of the cars in Sarasota are more than
$85,000. Yeah. Yeah.
This is just a beautiful one bedroom, one bath condo. You know, 7 miles to the beach, you know, maintenance free. Great little second, you know, second home, little getaway.
Yeah.
And, you know, the bathroom's been redone. And, you know, it's only a little over 700 square feet, but great value there.
That is
and
amazing.
It's beautiful, you know.
But you know, you don't think you can find something that kind of value here in Sarasota. You know, you think 85. We actually thought that was a typo.
We were we kept looking for the
other there's a number missing.
Definitely. And then we go back to Lakewood Ranch, which everyone loves Lakewood Ranch. I wanted to put this on here. $250,000. Gorgeous community. This is Summerfield Village. You're looking at a three-bedroom, two-bath, little over 1,700 square feet, beautiful single-family home. You know, tile throughout, brand new carpet, fresh paint. It is literally ready move-in condition. What a great value
that
to
is.
Be in an amazing school district, Lakewood Ranch, $250,000, beautiful
home.
And for a lot
that.
Of people getting in the school district like that
it's huge.
Is
that's
what
the first
you're
thing
trying
looking
to
for.
Do. Yeah, that's a
Absolutely.
Great deal.
Absolutely. So on the lake as well.
So you mentioned great value. So when you're looking for that, what should you do?
I love that question because, you know, a lot of people we hear, I want to steal. Mm-hmm. You know, great value is different to everybody.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you could get a steal, but if it doesn't have what you're looking for, then where's the value in that?
Yeah.
I say great value is getting, you know, the best home for you and the best location that has all of your amenities and upgrades and everything, and being within your price budget is huge. And there are plenty of great values out here. So,
All right. Speaking of which, here's all
right.
More.
We're going to shoot down south. This is on Venice. We're right on the intercoastal. Love this. This is the waterfront of Venice. You're looking at a two-bedroom, two-bath. This is literally a model home.
Wow.
Quality, model quality. This is actually what it is for sale. $575,000. Beautiful. Little over 1,700 square feet. And what I love about this is they literally did every single builder option add-on. And it is sold turnkey furnished. So absolutely gorgeous. The bathroom, Roman showers, granite countertops, Everything's been done up. This is out in the Lanai, so your view over the intercoastal waterway of the boats and jet skis and everything, and wow. It's just gorgeous.
That's a real walk-in.
And there's location and then everything you need inside.
Absolutely.
So, look at that.
So wait to this next one. I love this property. So we are in Sapphire Shores, Linda, where you live.
Oh, that'll
and,
be my neighbor.
Yeah, right on North Shore Drive. This is amazing. $750,000. Not another home like this, probably anywhere. Beautiful. It's 4-bedroom, 2.5-bath. When you go outside, this has a custom Balinese architecture, which this is, again, you can't find. Gorgeous lagoon, pool. It's a modern tropical oasis.
Very zen.
Very zen.
Yes. Yes. I feel peaceful
very
just
zen.
Looking at the picture.
And
I
so
like
beautiful.
Zen.
And what's so cool about these houses is they do a lot on the at the for the night lighting. You know, the ambiance at night. Wow. It's absolutely gorgeous with the fire pits.
And that's
everything.
Not even the dream home. It looks like a dream to
no.
me.
No, that's not the dream home. Yeah.
All right. And so we mentioned earlier that the market is shifting. What does that mean?
Yeah, well, definitely. Well, touch base on that in just a second. Longboat Key, though, I wanted to bring, this is our dream home for the week. Guys, this is amazing. This is on a half of an acre in a cul-de-sac on Longboat Key. Very interesting about this property. They're doing the beach renourishment right out here. So what's they're actually in September going to start building on to the beach.
Wow.
So as you buy in there, you're going to have, you know,
more
so
land.
Many more feet
you're
of beach.
You're going to get beach.
More
okay.
beach. And so if you're okay with dealing with, you know, the construction and stuff for a few months, you're going to have an incredible beach.
That's
so
that's
amazing.
Amazing.
$3.3 million.
Good to know.
Absolutely
okay.
love it. So.
Well, we'll talk about the marketing later.
Definitely. We'll hit that.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Andrew.
Yeah.
And we're so happy to be back. Now, if you want to contact Andrew about any of these properties, you can reach out to him at andrew@searchsarasotahomes.com. Mm-hmm. And we're really, really happy you're back.
I'm glad to be back.
And then we come back, we're going to view our email and on our hot topics. We'll be right back.
Mom needed more care than we could provide, so we called Granny Nannies. She now has around-the-clock caregivers, and we have peace of mind. Thanks to them, she's where she belongs, at home.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
On your TV. On your computer. On your camera. On your smartphone, on your Apple Watch. And now you can get ABC7, your Suncoast News on Fire TV. Just go to mysuncoast.com and click on the mobile tab for a list of fast and free downloads that deliver ABC7, your Suncoast News, on the go.
Thanks to my volunteer, I am a better reader.
Thanks to my volunteer, math seems simple now.
Thanks to my volunteer, I discovered new career goals.
I'm a volunteer for Sarasota County Schools, so I know I can make a difference. And you can too. Give an hour, change a life.
Tonight on ABC7 News at 7.
One of the pieces that we found out is there just what, while we communicated quite a bit through that rollout, there wasn't enough interaction with the community.
Parking meters coming back to downtown Sarasota. Find out what the city is doing to avoid the mistakes they made last time they were brought in and then removed. I'm Ray Collins. That plus our roundtable discussion.
Tonight on ABC7 News at 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you. Hurricane season is here, and so is the official Suncoast Hurricane Guide from ABC7. This essential resource arms you with vital information you need to protect your family and property when severe weather threatens the Suncoast, including how to create your readiness plan and survival kit, shelter locations, what to do with pets, and important phone numbers. Visit mysuncoast.com and download the official Suncoast Hurricane Guide from ABC7. Brought to you by the Florida Lottery.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today. Sleep on it tonight.
At Granny Nannies, we provide your loved ones with the care they deserve, compassionate and experienced help right where you need it most, at home. Visit us at grannynannies.com.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Welcome back. Well, yesterday we talked about a story involving Hooters being a sponsor for a Denver Cub Scout camp, and there's been a little bit of concern whether or not that was entirely appropriate. But we got a great email from one of our viewers that I want to share with you, because we love it when you write in with opinions on all these topics. It says, the staff at Hooters is sweet and friendly and treats kids like gold. This woman wrote in to say that she took the Sarasota American All-Stars to Hooters after clinching their District 16 title game to celebrate. So she was talking about what a great job Hooters did with those kids, nothing inappropriate, and the kids love the wings. And that is from Lisa. So I love the fact that Lisa wrote in, and there the kids are. They're celebrating, because, you know, it makes a really good point. As a mom, I was like, oh, I don't know if that's going to go over at a Cub Scout camp pretty well. But guess what? Yeah. Bo Beth made the great point of anybody spending time and energy donating with to kids and camps. Nice, we need to all support and be nice about
it. And they put on their jacket, so they were just
saying,
like anybody
at that
else.
The picture was harmless.
Exactly. So, Lisa, great point. We love your input, and cheers to the All-Star team. So thanks for celebrating. Good for them. All right, we are headed to the kitchen now to enjoy Italian sausage sandwiches. Can't wait.
ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
So many possibilities worth exploring. Minnesota Flooring.
Looking for carpet? Look no further. Minnesota Flooring has Smart Strand carpet as low as $1.79 per square foot. Installed, no add-ons or extras. Unbelievable? Minnesota Flooring can have in-stock carpet installed in your home in 48 hours for as low as $1.99 per square foot. Don't miss these prices. Visit Minnesota Flooring today.
From our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is an ABC 7 News Update.
Hello, I'm Scott Dennis. Here's what's coming up at the top of the hour. Solving Florida's algae bloom crisis. Governor Rick Scott is asking state lawmakers to spend millions on the environmental disaster. In Suncoast Traffic Watch, a serious crash in Ellenton this afternoon. Two semi-trucks overturned in the northbound lanes of the interstate near mile marker 225 around 2:30 this afternoon. FHB says strong winds lifted those trucks about 25 feet into the air, and the drivers believe it could have been a tornado. Both drivers are okay. All lanes were blocked initially. Now just the outside lane is blocked, but it is tying up a lot of traffic. Now over to John for more on the weather.
Yeah, we can show you those big storms too. They created a lot of rainfall, and we had some drier air filtering in, so perhaps we were looking at a downburst or microburst situation. Right now, some showers in inland areas. We'll talk about the rain chances for the rest of the evening across our area.
ABC 7's Pump Patrol, a list of the Suncoast's cheapest gas on mysuncoast.com.
Hurricane season is here, and Suncoast weather can go from this to this in seconds. So when severe weather threatens, count on the official Suncoast storm team at ABC 7.
We're armed with the most advanced weather technology so that we can bring you storm warnings faster and with more detail than ever before.
Plus, we focus on the Suncoast and track storms right down to your neighborhood.
On air, online, and on your mobile device, turn to the official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7. We're here for you. At ABC 7, it's all about being here for you. ABC 7 News at 7 with award-winning investigative journalist Alan Cohn. In-depth reporting and debate on important issues and stories in our community, with a featured topic of the day and a live roundtable discussion with community leaders and newsmakers, plus a quick recap of the day's top stories and weather. ABC 7 News at 7, weeknights. Now more than ever, we're here for you, Suncoast. Tomorrow at 5 on ABC 7's Good Morning Suncoast.
Hello, I'm Rebecca Vargas.
And I'm Don Brennan. Are you getting enough sleep at night? If not, you could be putting yourself at a greater health risk.
Tomorrow on Good Morning Suncoast, we'll show you how your sleep patterns could affect your chances of developing diabetes. Wendy?
And we are looking at some warm weather once again, and that may or may not help you sleep at all.
Tomorrow at 5 on ABC 7's Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you. Have you ever wondered what it's like to save a life? Find out by donating platelets at Suncoast Blood Bank.
I'm Haley Wilkes, ABC 7. Platelets aid in the clotting process and are vital in the treatment of cancer and surgical patients, trauma victims, and critically ill newborns. It's tough to keep enough on the shelves because they only last 5 days. To donate, call this number or visit scbb.org, and you can help save a life.
ABC 7 congratulates Suncoast Blood Bank on 65 years of serving our community.
Thanks to my volunteer, I am a better reader.
Thanks to my volunteer, math seems simple now.
Thanks to my volunteer, I discovered new career goals.
I'm a volunteer for Sarasota County Schools, so I know I can make a difference. And you can too. Give an hour, change a life.
At 4 on Suncoast View, tomorrow's greatest innovators are not taking this summer off. We're going to learn about Fab Lab with the Suncoast Science Center. They're going to bring science things to us. We'll see if we can keep up with some middle school minds. So are you confused by people live streaming their lives all around you? I know I am. Well, we're going to break down all the different live streaming apps and find out how they work. Plus, sounds of the Suncoast with a Bradenton native and Curry Station in the kitchen.
Welcome back. We are here with Chef Judy, who is speaking to my Italian side right now because we have delicious bread and sausages. I mean, you can't get any better than that.
You can't get it, and it's summer, and that summer just screams of sausage sandwiches. So let's get right into it. Valentino, the original one, about to celebrate their 10th anniversary on Clark. Bravo to them. They're also off University on Cooper Creek Boulevard. Big space. Now, as I said earlier, the bread. You got to have the tug of the bread.
Yes.
They have broccoli rabe. Wait for it. For people from New York, long, hot peppers. Wow. Look at the gourmet side.
Has some
pesto aioli and sun-dried tomatoes. But the standard sausage and pepper sandwich is so darn good. Thank you. And it's all about the bread. So they range between 10 and 12 bucks. And I'm telling you, I'd probably pay $100 for that. It's so
what do you think,
darn
Linda?
Good.
Delicious.
Valentino, and I love that they brought me a fat tire ale, because the only time I drink beer, and Joey's shaking his head, right, Joey? We'll go, we'll have a little Italian sandwich, we'll talk, and we'll have a fat tire ale. You got it.
Looks good.
Next, let's go to Geyer Sausage Kitchen.
Yes.
You can't have a sausage program without Geyer Sausage Kitchen. Now, they're really focused on what is their German tradition, which is the bratwurst. Look at the mini rolls. I mean,
those
how cute is that? You can set that up at home and make your own little bar with it. They have it in a version of peppers and onions. Mm-hmm. But look at this. They have a new thing. They have a brat burger.
Wow.
So
it's
a creative way to take sausages and turn it into a burger.
That's
as
great
well.
Idea.
And I've had one of those, and they're really delicious. So you have lots of different samplers and brats with sauerkraut, and so, so yummy. Now, when I say Piccolo's Italian Market, I say, in my next life, I'm going to be Italian, and I'm going to live at that place. It's so good in Gulfgate. I love it. And Anthony, we want to thank you for all these great artisan breads, because on top of the great bread that he has, he brought in so many beautiful pieces. But look at this. Chicken sausage with broccoli rabe and provolone. Of course, the standard is the classic, is that Italian
Parmesan
sausage and peppers. But wait, there's more. He actually makes his own homemade sausage, and he puts sometimes broccoli rabe right into the sausage, or peppers and onions into the sausage. Joey is rubbing his belly. Joey, you need to be on this segment, because I know. And
Beth has
everyone in the audience.
I'm already digging
like,
in.
Look at Joey. Look at Joey. Joey, you got two coming your way, love. We're the fat tire. But fontina cheese, so I'm telling you.
Can I go in?
You go in. You can all go in. But like I said, think about
thing.
Having like a giant one for, you know, your summer pool parties. It's just really fun. Piccolo's Italian Market, it's not only the
this
bread,
is authentic,
it's the homemade
right here.
Sausage. Hey, spoken from the Italian one in the group. Okay, right over here, Mozzarella Fella.
They're great,
too. Again, you know, right here on Main Street. You know, there is something with the name. Valentino, Piccolo's, Mozzarella Fella, right? We've got a theme here. Well, Mozzarella Fella has some really beautiful ones with parsley and cheese, and very creative fennel sausage with broccoli, kale, and melted provolone. So you know what I say?
It's healthy.
You don't have to eat the kale salad. Get it on your sausage,
exactly.
And you're fine, right?
All about it.
So, and look, Steph's
going
so
in.
Good, but she's
gonna have
being
a little
so
cheese.
Good.
Mozzarella Fella was the first place I ever ate when I came to Sarasota.
Oh.
The first place I had lunch, and it won me over.
Yeah, so, I can understand that.
They're really great.
And we eat similar tastes. So yes, I'm looking forward to taking you to all the other places as well. So mozzarella fella on Main Street. And again, a variety of different type of sausage sandwiches. Mm-hmm. Notice the theme. It's not just your onions and peppers anymore. Mm-hmm. Right down to our friends at Mandeville Beer Garden. Get yourself a big stein full of beer, and you can have a Reuben bratwurst on a roll. You have so many different, the lager beer grilled pork brat with raw onion. Wow. I mean, so many things to choose from. You're going to really love it with the grilled rye bread. So no matter where choose, whether it's Italian sausage or whether it's bratwurst, you have your summer ready to go.
And you got everybody covered from Italian Rebecca to German Stephanie.
Perfect.
All right, thank you, Judy. And I got to tell you, this bread, Bo Beth and I are about ready to break bread together.
I know. Joey, we've got two for you. Joey, I swear we have two.
All right, Rebecca, thanks for joining us.
Thank
Great to
you.
See you. Judy, amazing as always. Be sure to take some time and enjoy the Suncoast view.